ओके स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू ऑल फोर सी लर्निंग क्लासेस इन द लास्ट टॉपिक वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इंटेंसिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड नाउ टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग प्रॉब्लम्स रिगार्डिंग इंटेंसिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड सी इन द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज फॉर सपोज इफ थ्री चार्जेस ओके टू चार्जेस नेगेटिव चार्जेस माइनस क्यू एंड ए पॉजिटिव चार्ज प्लस क्यू आर placed at the corners of equilateral triangle of side A. Okay, so let us take this is an equilateral triangle. Three charges. Okay, let us take this is A, B, C is an equilateral triangle of side A. Side A. Two negative charges. Okay. Two charges, negative charges, minus q, and one positive charge plus q. So plus q is kept at the corner A. Minus charge is kept at the B, and again another minus charge, minus q is kept at the corner C. Okay, three charges. Okay, two are negative charges, and third one is. Positive charge kept at the vertices of an equilateral triangle of side A. Now, if you place another positive charge at the centroid, then what is a net force acting on this charge? Okay. By the Coulomb's law, we should calculate first of all what is the force acting on this charge. If a positive charge plus q is kept at the centroid of the triangle, what is the net force acting on this positive charge? Okay, see, listen. This positive charge, what is the side is here? Draw one perpendicular bisector from the vertices. Okay, now this portion A, B, C, let us take this is a point D. What is the BD value is A by 2. BD value is A by 2. Similarly, CD value is also A by 2. Okay, now this is already we said that this is an equilateral triangle. The three corners are equidistant from the centroid. We should find this value, R value, we should calculate. This is, let us take, this is R. Okay, let us take G be the centroid of the equilateral triangle. Cap G is a centroid of the triangle. We should calculate first of all R value. See, this is already an equilateral triangle. What is the angle here? It is 60 degrees. The bisector angle means half of that, this value is 30 degrees. Okay. Now, BGD is a right angle triangle here. From the figure, triangle BGD. Okay, what is cos 30 is equals to cos 30 degrees is equals to adjacent. What is adjacent here? A by 2. Okay, and hypotenuse is R. So R is equals to A by 2 by cos 30. Cos 30 value is root 3 by 2. So what is the value here? A by root 3. Means the distance of the centroid from any one of the corner. Okay, is R is equals to A by root 3. Now, calculate the force. Here, what is the force as acting on this charge? We are calculating the net force acting on the charge plus Q kept at the centroid. Okay, this is a positive charge here. This is also positive charge. So, distance is R. But here negative charge, this is a positive. But my same magnitude, equal distance. Here also same magnitude, equal distance. So, this positive charge is repelled by this charge kept at the centroid. Let us take the direction is of force is F1. This is a direction of force F1. And this positive charge is attracted by the negative charge. This is a direction of F2. Okay. And again this positive charge is attracted by the another negative charge. This is a direction F3. Okay. The magnitudes of F1 is equals to magnitude of F2 is equals to magnitude of F3 here. Okay. So what are the values here? We may write these values 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus q plus q. The sign indicates only direction is different. Q into q, q square by r square, which is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by, what is r value here? We got a by root 3, a by root 3 whole square, which can be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by a square by 3 becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3 q square by a square. So these are the magnitudes of f1 is equal to f2 is equal to f3, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3 q square by a square. Okay, but if you are observing these diagram, what is f1 to f2 and f3 are at an angle of 120 degrees, because this is a right angle triangle. Here what is the angle already bisector? 30 degrees, this is 90. 90 plus 30, 120. What is the remaining? It is 60 degrees. 60 here also 60. So the angle between F2 and F3, the angle between F2 and F3 is 120 degrees. Okay, what is the values? F2 and F3 are equal magnitude. Magnitude of F2 is equals to magnitude of F3, and angle between them is 120 degrees. So when two vectors having equal magnitude and the angle between them is 120 degrees, okay, then what is the resultant of these two is equals to either of the vector. The resultant of F2 and F3 is equals to either F2 or F3. So by the parallelogram law of vectors, if you substitute angle theta is 120 degrees, then you will get resultant is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by r square. Let here F23 be the resultant of F2 and F3. Okay, what is value? F23 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by 3 q square by a square. So what is its direction? It is a vector. We should specify the direction. See, from this diagram, F2 and F3 are 120 degrees with each other, and F1 is along vertical here downwards direction. The resultant of F2 and F3 is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3 q by a square, and it is along the direction of F1. Bisector of F2 and F3, that is along the direction of F1. F23 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3 q by a square acts along F1. So now F1, F23 are in the same direction. Therefore, what is the net force? The net force is equals to vector sum of F23 plus F1. But these two are equal or not? F1 is same, F23 is also same. So what you will get? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3 q square by a square plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3 q square by a square. Okay? Which is equals to 3 q square plus 3 q square, 6 q square by 4 pi epsilon naught a square. Okay, or it can be written as 3 q square by 2 pi epsilon naught a square. Okay, this is a net force acting on the charge kept at the centroid of the equilateral triangle. Okay, two are negative charges, one of them is positive, and another positive charge is kept at the centroid. The net force acting on the charge is 3 q square by 2 pi epsilon naught a square. Okay, okay, second one. Now two charges, okay, one is plus q, two charges plus q and minus 3q. Two charges plus q and minus 3q are separated by certain distance. What are two charges? Plus q and minus 3q are separated by certain distance apart in the free space. Then the intensity of electric field at the at the location of plus q is E bar. It is given as E bar. Then what is the intensity of electric field at the location of minus 3q? Okay, here what is given? A given one condition in the problem, E bar be the intensity of electric field. Intensity of electric field at the location of plus q. At the location of plus q. Okay. At the location of plus q, what are here? One of them is positive charge, the other is negative charge and having different magnitudes. So plus q minus 3q are separated by certain distance in the free space, and given what is E bar be the intensity of electric field at the location of plus q. Then asking what is the intensity of electric field at the location of minus 3q in terms of E bar. In terms of E bar, see, what is, we know that intensity of electric field due to the point charge, we have an expression. What is intensity of electric field due to point charge is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Here where q be the charge, r be the distance. So let us take here also, these two charges are separated by a distance r. Here E bar be the intensity of electric field at the location of plus q means, so we are calculated the intensity of electric field at this position by this charge. Therefore we may write, what is E bar is equals to, E bar is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is the charge? 3q. No need to write negative sign, it indicates only the direction. 3q by r square, where r is the distance of the charge, distance where we are determining the electric field from the source charge. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3q by r square. So this is the intensity of electric field at the location of q by this charge, that is minus 3q. What is the, this charge is negative or not? If it is a negative, what is the direction of electric field? Radially inwards direction. So this is the direction of E bar. Okay, the direction of E bar is towards the minus 3q. Okay, already we know that. Let us take, this is the equation number 1. Now what is second one? We should calculate the intensity of electric field at minus 3q. Means we are calculating intensity at this position by the charge q. Here you should write, let E1 bar be the intensity of electric field. Intensity of electric field at the location of minus 3q. Okay, then what is E1 bar is equals to, we may write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay, what is the charge? Here we are calculating, means we are calculating the field at this position by this charge, q by r square. Let us take, this is equation number 2. And this is a positive or not? What is the direction of electric field? Radially outwards. So this is the direction of E1 bar. The direction of E1 bar and E bar are in the same directions. Okay. If you are observing these two equations, can we write like this? From equation number 1 and 2. Okay, what is E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 3q by r square. E1 bar is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Here only 3 is there. So if you are observing these equation number 1 and 2, E bar can be written as E bar is equals to 3 E1 bar. Okay. Here 3 as it is, remaining 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square is E1 bar. Therefore, what is E1 bar is equals to? E1 bar is equals to E bar by 3. Okay. E1 bar is equals to E bar by 3 plus E bar by 3. Okay. When two charges q and minus 3q are separated by certain distance in the free space, the location of the intensity of electric field at the location of plus q is given as E bar. We should calculate the intensity of electric field at minus 3q, okay, by the another charge plus q, which is E1 bar is equals to E bar by 3. See, when two charges 4 micro coulomb minus 9 micro coulombs, what is q1 is equals here 4 micro coulombs and q2 is equals to minus 9 micro coulombs. For two charges, one is 4 micro coulomb, the other is minus 9 micro coulombs, are separated by a distance of 0.5 meters apart. And the null point is obtained at a distance x from the point A. The null point is obtained at a distance x from the point A and y from the point B. Then asking what are the values of x and y. Okay. Let us take what is the null point is obtained at a point P by the first charge q1. Let us take the distance is x here. X be the distance of the null point from lesser magnitude of the charge. And what is given, the location of null point from the second charge is given, this is y. Okay. Let us take the 0.5 meters, it is nothing but r. The distance between the two charges is r here. Now, we have an expression to locate the null points. What is the expression for two null points is? Null x is equals to, we have an expression. That is x is equals to r by under root of q2 by q1 plus r minus 1. And we know that what is positive sign for like charges. Positive sign for like charges. And a negative sign used for unlike charges. Okay, now here what is, one is positive, the other is negative. So unlike charges, you should take negative sign. What is the formula? X is equals to r by under root of q2 by q1 minus 1. What is r value here? 0.5. What is a q2? Q2 is always higher magnitude, no need to take negative sign. Okay, so what is the value? 9 micro coulomb. Q1 is 4 micro coulomb minus 1. So that is equals to 0.5 by under root of 9 by 4 becomes 3 by 2 minus 1, which is equals to 0.5 by 1.5 minus 1, that is 0.5 by 0.5, which is equals to 1 meter. Okay. Now we got the x value is 1 meter. The location of null point from lesser magnitude of the charge is 1 meter. Then what is y is equal to? Can we write y is equal to r plus x? So y is equal to r plus x. That is 0.5 plus 1. That is equals to 1.5 meters. Therefore, x is equals to 1 meter and y is equals to 1.5 meters. These are the distances of the null point from the q1 charge and q2 charge. Okay. Next problem. If two charges having equal magnitude opposite signs or kept at the two vertices of an equilateral triangle of side 5 cm, then what is the resultant intensity of electric field at the empty corner? Now let us consider this is an equilateral triangle. Okay, two charges having the equal magnitude. Listen here, Q1 is equals to plus 10 power minus 9 coulombs. Plus 10 power minus 9 coulombs. And the second charge Q2 is minus 10 power minus 9 coulombs. That means 1 nanocoulomb minus 1 nanocoulomb. Okay, kept at the two corners of an equilateral triangle of side 5 cm. This is 5 cm side. Okay, what is now we should calculate the resultant intensity of electric field at the third corner. Means we should calculate intensity of electric field at point A. So first of all, calculate the intensity of electric field at the point A by the charge Q1. Right here, let E1 bar be the intensity of electric field. Electric field at point A. At point A, what is its value? E1 bar is equals to 1 by 4, write the magnitude, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is the charge Q1 here? Q1 by R1 square. Okay. What is Q1? Plus 10 power minus 9. R is a distance 5 cm. Okay. That is 9 into 10 power 9. What is value of Q1? 10 power minus 9 by R1 square 5 cm. 5 into 10 power minus 2 whole square. Minus 9 plus 9 get cancelled. That is E1 is equals to 9 into 9 by 25 into 10 power minus 4, which can be written as 90,000 by 25. 25 threes are 75, 3600. That is 3600 newton per coulomb. 3600 newton per coulomb even. So what is its direction? Is this is a positive charge. The direction of electric field is radially outwards. This is a direction of E1 here. But we should calculate the resultant intensity of electric field. Here we have another charge. What is negative charge is there? What is its magnitude? Q2 is equals to 10 power minus 9 coulombs. So again, what is later E2 be the intensity of electric field. At point A by the negative charge, by the Q2, that is equals to minus 10 power minus 9 coulombs. Okay, so whatever it may be, the magnitude is same. Okay, whether it is 1 nanocoulomb, here it is a minus 1 nanocoulomb, but the separation is also same or not? So what you will get, E2 is also same. What is the formula again? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 by R square. R is same, magnitude is same. But what is the direction only different? Negative sign. Negative sign means what is the direction of intensity of electric field is radially inwards. So this is the direction of E2 here. Towards the charge. Okay. This is away from the charge. Radially outwards and this is radially inwards. So what you will get finally, you will get E2 is also same. That is, what is the magnitude of E1 and E2 are same, which is equals again 3600 newton per coulomb. But we need the resultant. So we should know the angle between E1 and E2. This is an equilateral triangle. What is already we said that ABC is an equilateral triangle of side 5 cm. What is the angle here? 60 degrees. And what about these angle? between E1 and E2, which is 120 degrees. Okay? The angle between E1 and E2 is 120 degrees. Angle between E1 and E2 bar is 120 degrees. And we know that if two vectors having equal in magnitude and the angle between them is 120 degrees, then the resultant of the two vectors is equals to either of the vector. Okay, therefore what is E net is equals to here, actually vector sum of E1 bar plus E2 bar, but here angle between them is 120 degrees. Okay, the angle between E1 and E2 is 120 degrees and its magnitude is 3600 Newton per Coulomb. Therefore, the net intensity of electric field is equals to either of the vector, that is 3600 Newton per Coulomb. Okay, so same, we are calculating just the resultant intensity of electric field when two charges having equal magnitude but different signs are kept at the vertices of an equilateral triangle of side 5 cm, we are calculating the resultant of intensity of electric field at the third corner. Here magnitudes are same and the angle between them is 120 degrees, so that we got what is the net intensity of electric field is 3600 Newton per Coulomb. Okay. See. Next one, fifth problem. For suppose if two charges are separated by certain distance, they execute a force. Let us take the two charges are Q1 and Q2. Okay, we doesn't know whether these two are like charges or unlike charges. Separated by certain distance, let it be R. And execute a force of 200 newtons. Execute a force of 200 newtons. Two charges separated by certain distance, execute a force of 200 newtons. In the second case, the charge of any one of them is increased by 10%, the other is decreased by 10%. What is, let us take the Q1 dash be the charge in the second case. Increased by 10% means Q1 plus 10% of Q1, which is equals to 110 Q1 by 100, can be written as 11 by 10 Q1. And the second charge is decreased by 10%. Q2 dash is equals to Q2 minus 10% of Q2, which is equals to 90 Q2 by 100. Okay, that is 9 Q2 by 10. What is a two charges initially separated by certain distance, they execute a force of 200 newtons. And in the second case, one of the charge is increased by 10%, the other charge is decreased by 10%. So the first charge becomes 11 by 10 Q1, second charge becomes 9 by 10 Q2. Then separated through the same distance, what is the force in the second case? Here R1 is R, here also what is the same distance, R2 is R. We have one formula, that is F1 by R, we may write F2 by F1 is equals to Q1 dash Q2 dash by Q1 Q2. F2 by F1 is equals to Q1 dash Q2 dash by Q1 Q2 because the distance is same. What is the value? F2 we are calculating, F1 is given 200. Q1 dash Q2 dash 11 by 10 Q1 into 9 by 10 Q2 by Q1 Q2. Q1, Q2 cancel. What is F2 by 200 is equals to 11 by 10, 11 into 9, 99 by 100. So what is F2 is equals to 99 into 2, that is 198 newtons. Okay. In the second case, what is the force between them is 198 newtons. Initially, they execute a force of 200 newtons. But one of them is increased by 10%, the other is decreased by 10%, separated through the same distance. Now, what is the final force is? The final force between them is 198 newtons. Okay? Right.